Hello friends, welcome to the next video. And today I would like to focus on how to find out the developed length of the design sheet. Okay, so let's get started. Click on file, take new file, select this subtype sheet meter, untick this, click on OK. Next, make it into millimeters. And next, take this planner from the front on the front plane and make it sketch view. Take this rectangle, center rectangle from the ribbon and draw it from the center of any dimension. Click on this OK. And this is 1 millimeter thickness sheet. Make it 2 millimeter thickness. Click on this green tick mark. Over here the primary wall is generated. And next, I would like to make this flat. Okay, on this side, take that flat and select this downward edge, so that flat is generated. And click on the thickness. Put 30 over here. You can see. Okay, this bend radius is generated over here. You can change it. I would like to make it 40 like this. Okay. Next, click on this green tick mark. Now the object is ready for performing that operations. So first of all, click on this unbend group. Okay, and here there is a option. Click on this unbend. Okay, now this is the main command which has been used in industry, because now this object is in bend form. Okay, so if they said to you calculate developed length for this drawing, okay, now here is the bend also, radius bend also, and this is in, and this wall is perpendicular to this wall, so how could you find the total length if you have to put the order for the materials? So it is necessary to have the dimensions like length and width of the sheet. Okay, so click on this green tick mark. Okay, so here the flat is generated, and now for its dimensions, okay, so first of all click on this file, and here is option prepare. Okay, and here one is there is an option model properties. Click on this model properties. Okay, so now here is some theory part also. So for defining this developed length, we also have to keep in mind bend allowance. There is one concept there like bend allowance also, and we have most of the time we have to define that y factor for bend allowance. Okay, so it depends on the material, whether the material is hard or material is soft. Okay, so depending on that, if the material is harder, so there will be a large developed length as compared to soft, and if the material is soft, so there will be less developed length as compared to hard material. Okay, so basically the y factor is took 0.55 as default. If you wanted to change, so click on the change, and here is the value factor, value is 0.5 as default. Okay, so we can change from here. So if you change this y factor value, so developed length will also be changing. Okay, so it is depend on this y factor also. I make this 0.7. okay, click on apply and okay, and close this. Okay, now go to annotate, and click on this analysis, and here is one group major, and from the major select this distance, and next here we can go for the developed length. Okay, so press Ctrl key on your keyboard and select this upper edge. Okay, now here it is indicated by the green mark. Now come to this second side edge, this upper edge, zoom this and again click the control key, okay, and select this upper edge. Now both edges are selected for the distance, and here you can see the distance is, here you can see 1175, okay, 0.95 millimeters. So this is the developed length, okay, this much. And simultaneously again click on the distance, zoom this and click on this edge. Next click the control key on your keyboard and select this edge also, okay, so that you can get this width of the sheet also. Here is the width, okay, 625.97 millimeters. In this way, this will help you in the during working in the industry. Most of the times, if you are working in the sheet metal or fabrication industries, okay, or this is all about this. And thank you very much, friend, for watching this video. And I would request those friends who are new on this channel, so kindly subscribe the channel, will help you out to improving your skills also. And thank you very much.